To add or subtract rational expressions, we have to have like denominators, which means to add fractions, the denominators must be the same. Notice in both of these examples, we do have like denominators. So to add or subtract rational expressions with like denominators, we add or subtract the numerators, and the denominator stays the same. So for this first example, the denominator will stay 3, and then we'll have the quantity 2x plus 9 plus the quantity 4x plus 15. Notice how when adding these, I put each numerator in a set of parentheses. And while it's not required for addition, it is for subtraction. So I think it's a good habit to always include parentheses around each numerator when adding or subtracting rational expressions. But now we will go ahead and clear the parentheses. And to do this, we could think of distributing a positive 1, which we know would not change the signs of any terms. So we'd just have a denominator of 3, and then we'd have 2x plus 9 plus 4x plus 15. And now we want to combine the like terms in the numerator. 2x plus 4x would be 6x. And 9 plus 15 is equal to 24. Now we need to be careful here. We cannot simplify just the 6x and the 3 because we cannot simplify across this addition. So to simplify this, we need to first factor the numerator. Notice how there's a common factor of 6 between 6x and 24. So we'd have 6 times the quantity x plus 4 all over 3. And now that it's factored, notice the 6 and the 3 do share a common factor of 3. This would simplify to 1, this would simplify to 2. So this simplifies to 2 times the quantity x plus 4, or if we distribute, we'd have 2x plus 8. Either of these two forms would be acceptable. Let's take a look at our second example. Again, we have a common denominator, so we can go ahead and subtract. So our denominator is going to stay 15. And then we're going to have the quantity x plus 9 minus the quantity 6x minus 1. And here's the reason why it's important to always include parentheses around each numerator. We want to clear these parentheses so we can think of distributing this minus, or if it's helpful, we can think of distributing a negative 1 here. And again, we can think of distributing a positive 1 to eliminate these parentheses. So this would give us, again, a denominator of 15. And then here we'd have x plus 9. And then here when we distribute a negative 1, we would have a negative 6x or minus 6x. And then negative 1 times negative 1 becomes plus 1. Notice when subtracting this quantity, the sign of each term changes. And now we'll combine the like terms in the numerator. 1x minus 6x is negative 5x. And 9 plus 1 would be plus 10. Again, we cannot just simplify the negative 5 and the 15. To simplify this, we want to factor out the greatest common factor from the numerator. So the greatest common factor here would be 5. Let's go ahead and factor out negative 5, though. That would leave us with x minus 2. Remember, when factoring a negative out, it's going to change the sign of each term. Let's go ahead and write 15 as 3 times 5. Notice in this form, we have a common factor of 5 here and here. That simplifies to 1. So we have negative the quantity x minus 2 all over 3. Or if we wanted to, we could distribute the negative sign, which is like distributing negative 1. Notice how we'd have negative x plus 2. So again, either of these two forms would be acceptable. Okay, we'll look at some more examples in the next video.